Right, this morning we are in the Nopwood area, and Dave has been with us how many times, Dave?
Seven times.
Yep. 7 times that he's hunted with us. He nearly hunted all the other animals and all the species that we've got. So we did a rhino yesterday, a rhino dart, and we decided that we want to do some of the exotics today. So today we're going to try and stalk a golden wildebeest. It's a bull that's been kicked out by the herd, so probably he'll be by himself or running with a blesbuck. Beautiful golden wildebeest, and that's what we're going to try and hunt this morning.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Let's see. We're going to try and sneak over this little hill and see if we can see them on the other side. Get into those trees. If we can low, little lower, we should get to there. Good. That's a solid hit. It's perfect. I mean, it's really a nice bull, but that's a good shot. You shot him right behind the shoulders. I saw the blood coming out there. Excellent. Hey, he's such a good shot.
No, when I was on the stacks, man.
You were good. I mean, this was a great shot, man. Let's check. There you go. Nice and fat. It's in good condition. Since my friend, you did great. Let me just explain to you what happened here. In the past, all these wildebeest were selected for the color. It is a mutation that started in Botswana, and a guy by the name of York, he saw the golden wildebeest. It came out naturally. And then he started selecting for that specific gene. And that's how they bred the golden wildebeest. So it's not something that was developed, it's just something that came out naturally in the wild. And we just isolated them and bred with them. And today their numbers has grown so much that there are some of them available to hunt now. And the prices in the beginning was just too expensive. They were ridiculously expensive because people wanted them, and that urge that I want a golden wildebeest because it's such a pretty animal. And now today, I don't know how many, I think there must be a few thousand of them already. And they breed with a normal wildebeest, and on the third generation, the color changes like this. So in the future, they will definitely be available to hunt. And I think you are one of the first people to hunt a golden wildebeest. Definitely the first with us, but I think one of the first ones in the country to hunt the golden wildebeest. So congratulations on that. It's a beautiful animal and a fantastic specimen.
Thank you.
You did good. Thank you very much.